I'm 60 years old, and I have a lump on the back of my neck, and I call it my baby. When I first noticed the lump, it was only the size of a pea. It took about 5 years to get to the size it is now. It's very miserable because I can't do anything. I can't turn my neck like I want to. It pulls all the way in here. When my baby was smaller, I was a lot active. I could move around and go places and do things and didn't think nobody was staring at my neck. I told the doctor to take it out, and they just bypassed and did what they wanted to do. My doctor says, oh, you lose weight, it'll go away. Ha, okay. It didn't go nowhere. I was a school bus driver for 11 years. I enjoyed driving school buses. Now, when I sit in a car, it's very uncomfortable, but I will not give up driving.
Have you seen the mirror?
No. When I turn, I have to turn like this, and I have to move my whole body. Am I good on that side?
Yep, you can on both sides.
And that's why I got a co-pilot.
You got a car coming?
No, I don't.
On the right-hand side, yes, you do. Sometimes, to be honest, when my mom is driving, I'm just scared. Because she just can't turn her head around.
I wasn't trying to run over you.
You gotta come to a stop here, man.
No, Dale, I wanna keep going. You're gonna give me a knife, son. Raising my arm and stuff like this, it bothers me. I have to sit down at the table and chop up food and then have my co-pilot take it over to the stove and actually stir it up. I wish Laydell could enjoy his life and not to have to take care of me. I really feel guilty taking up his time. And you know, if he gets in the room and he decides, well, I'm gonna watch a movie, and right in the middle of the movie, we're calling, Liddell! And without a hesitation, he gets up, and he does. Liddell, can you bring me my drink? He hangs in there, he hangs in no matter what. Thank you so much, can I have a fork? And he does whatever we need to be done.
Me and my mom are really close. We're best friends. I always keep her schedule. I make sure she eats. I clean her bathtub. You know, I make sure her clothes are clean and things like that.
Dale, hand me my glasses. Thanks.
You all right?
My neck hurts. And I can't get this started, so I'm getting irritated.
I do not see my mother as the burden.
Would you thread that for me?
I'm just glad I'm here to help her out.
Adele is my everything. And if it weren't for him, I would make it. I feel like he needs a life of his own.
I'll see you later.
Okay, thank you, baby. So I'm praying that Dr. Lee could take this baby out of my neck.
I have a patient today, her name is Belinda. She does not live very far. She has a big bump on the back of her neck, so I am curious to see what this is and whether I can help her.
You going in there and watch the surgery?
No, not with no needles. I can't watch, you get stuck up.
Oh, come on.
I probably pass out.
Belinda?
Come on, you can go back this far.
I'm not going back.
I got a little bit of butterflies in my stomach, get a little nervous what Dr. Lee's going to find out.
You ready for today?
Yeah, I am. I hope she can get rid of baby. Baby been a pain in my butt for a long time.
Dr. Lee is going to be in just a moment, OK?
OK, right. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
How are you?
I'm well, thank you. I'm Sandra. It's nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
Welcome.
Thank you.
What are you here for?
I'm here because I got a knot in the back of my neck.
I can see a little peak of something back here. Almost pushing your neck forward, I feel like,
yeah,
huh?
It is.
Oh, that's no fun.
No.
That must affect your ability to do a lot of the things you like to do, huh?
Yes, ma'am, it does. I do a lot of crafts and arts and stuff like that.
I like that stuff, too.
You do?
I do.
I brought you something.
You did?
Yes, ma'am.
Because I could talk about this stuff. Oh, my gosh. This is beautiful. This is all like wire craft, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
That's so gorgeous. Maybe I could do something for you. Maybe we can see if we can take this bump off for you, because I think that will help
you. So lovely, yes.
I'm hoping that'll help you move around a little bit more and, you know, maybe be a little bit more independent. My hand might be a little chilly, okay?
So, you know, your hands are warmer.
Oh, well, it's pretty big here, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
And it causes you some pain, especially with movement, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. It is soft, it moves around, it's compressible, so that's a good sign. It does feel a little bit more firm over here.
Yeah.
So that's a little concerning to me. Is it fluid? Is it fat? Is it a cyst? I'm not really sure. There are really two things that I'm thinking about here. If this is just a regular fatty deposit, it's really not the best thing for me to do an excision. The best method is, if this is a fat pad, is to do liposuction and just suck the fat out. But if this is a lipoma, the best decision is to make an excision. There you go. Okay. You okay?
I just want to get it over and done with.
That's right. That's what we're gonna do. Get it over and done with. I need to proceed with caution right now because I want to make sure that I keep this excision as small as possible and trying to determine as soon as I can whether this is really a lipoma. Okay. Or is this just a fatty mass that I can't really remove very well with a standard excision? Let's get rid of this little friend on your shoulder here.
Okay.
Make sure nothing ever hurts, okay?
Okay.
You feeling okay? You breathing okay and everything, right? You let me know if you're ever in any distress.
I will.
Okay. Gonna carefully look. This looks like a lipoma.
It looks like Belinda has a lipoma here. I just hope that it's not connected to deeper structures underneath. I hope it's not holding on to her and that I could just pop this out nice and easy.
I'm just gonna kind of loosen it up with my finger.
You're not bothering me, you're fine.
Good. I'm trying to get it out of a tiny little hole here so we keep you looking cute. We got it. Let me put them out on this table here a minute.
This is a lipoma jackpot. This is why I love to remove lipomas. I'm gonna send the tissue to pathology to confirm whether this is indeed a lipoma, but it looks really good.
What did you call this thing here?
This is my baby.
Called it your baby? Well, I'll let you hold your baby after it in a little bit.
Yeah, okay.
I'll deliver a baby for you anytime.
Okay. I hope I don't get no more of them.
I know, I hope not either. All right, we're all good. Let me show it to you. You wanna see it?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, I'll show you how cute it is.
Wow. That's what it looked like.
Yeah, it's actually two main lobes.
I see it is. Those twins, huh?
Yeah, it's like twins. Here's your lipoma.
Wow. It's weird. When Dr. Lee handed me my lipoma, I felt like Jell-O wiggling around. It's been born. Sorry.